cold weather environments. Not only are they uncomfortable, but you also lose finger dexterity. It's hard enough to open a pickle jar when your hands are freezing, much less fire a weapon, or even enter some vital information into a tablet. Put on gloves, and you're still a little bit more comfortable, but doing everything is still a pain. Well, what if you can warm up the blood before it even reaches your hands? Military Times editor Sarah Sicard traveled to Natick, Massachusetts, to the lab at the U.S. Army's Thermal Mountain Medical Division. There, she got to experience the cold and see the tech that might keep your hands in the fight, even when it's freezing.
So can you explain a little bit about where we are and what we're looking at?
Yes, we're at the U.S. Army Research Institute of Environmental Medicine, and I work in the Thermal and Mountain Medicine Division. So we study human performance in heat, cold, high altitude, and subterranean environments. And we're here looking at some devices to try to improve manual dexterity in the cold and allow soldiers to do their jobs much better. Because when you put gloves on, you lose your manual dexterity. It decreases by about 60 to 70%, which is quite significant. So we wanted to be able to improve dexterity with bare hands. And we can see that if we're in extremely cold environments, we could see eventually that we could keep their hands comfortable. So then if they have to like maybe take off their mittens to do a task, they can perform that task in that extremely cold environment and then put them back on when they're done.
So what are we looking at here?
So these are several prototypes that we've developed over the years trying to improve hand blood flow and finger temperatures during cold exposure. So this first one we developed 5 years ago when we were coming up with the concept of where we should provide heat at a low power and at a low battery cost. And so we did some testing in our laboratory here, and we found that if we could just place this around the forearm, that we could improve finger temperatures and hand temperatures by about 3 degrees Celsius. And that translated into about a 50% improvement in manual dexterity and about a 90% improvement in finger strength. The idea was to take that prototype idea and then build a device that has a self-sustained battery and that could be worn by a person in a field environment. And so when we plug that in, we'll heat that heater up to about 42 degrees Celsius, or about 107 degrees Fahrenheit.
Physiologically, you know, how does forearm heat translate into finger dexterity?
So what's happening is essentially is that when we move heat from the heater into the arm, that heat will eventually, through blood flow, make its way down into the hand and into the finger. So when people are in cold environments, their dexterity starts to decrease. And after, you know, it gets lower than about 60 degrees Fahrenheit, it starts to decrease quite rapidly. And so what we're trying to do is just increase that finger temperature. And when we raise that finger temperature, we're also increasing the dexterity of the fingers.
So when do you think that soldiers could see this on the battlefield?
We hope to see this sometime like in about 2028, 2030.
Now that you've heard what it's about, let's take a look inside the chamber.
So can you tell us a little bit about where we are right now?
Yes, of course. So this is one of our thermal environmental chambers. So they're about 12 feet by 12 feet where we control the environmental conditions.
And what kind of experiments do you guys do in here?
So we study how different individuals respond to heat stress or cold stress. So oftentimes warfighters have to go into hot or cold environments. And so we test different interventions to see how we can improve their physical performance.
And what temperatures do these two chambers go up to or down to?
Yeah, so they go down to about freezing, so roughly 0 degrees Celsius or 32 degrees Fahrenheit. And we can heat them up all the way to about 50 degrees Celsius, which is about 122 degrees Fahrenheit.
And, you know, what sort of areas do these experiments touch on? Is it, you know, food, clothing, like how, you know, what kind of physiological responses do you guys test?
Yeah, so we can test various intervention strategies. So some of what we test are, we test different clothing items to see whether they keep soldiers warmer or keep them cooler in heat stress. We test various nutritional interventions and how we can use those to improve performance in extreme environments. We can study how people adapt to different environments. So we can have individuals in these chambers repeatedly and then study how they adapt to cold or hot environments.
And how cold is it in here right now?
It's about freezing, so it's about 32 degrees Fahrenheit.
So I think we're gonna get out of here.